This presentation will give you an overview of the techniques we use to solve the unsteady flow equations. These are the equations, they're partial differential equations, and they're quite difficult to solve. But we're going to use, there are several methods here. The surge program uses the wave plan method, which is one that we've developed that offers some advantages of being intuitive and much easier to prepare the models. The models themselves are composed of line segments, components such as pumps and valves, junctions, which include open and closed ends, and surge control devices. And these are all shown here. There's a pipeline, here's a valve, here's a surge control device. Now the method that we use, the wave plan method, is simply described here. Pressure waves are generated at the source of a disturbance, such as this valve closing. The waves then travel at sonic speed and at junctions and at components such as pumps, they're reflected and transmitted. So this wave travels down this line at sonic speed. It now gets transmitted down the adjacent lines, reflected back into this line. These waves then go on. This wave travels to the pump, affects conditions at the pump, and gets reflected off of there. This wave goes to the valve, affects conditions there, and gets reflected, and so on. So this is the process that we use to solve the equations. Some of the key equations that we use, pressure wave, of course, travels at sonic speed, and it changes the pressure by amount delta P and the velocity by the amount delta V. This very simple equation that relates the pressure change in feet head to the flow change, the constant is wave speed over GA. And since wave speed is pretty high, this is a fairly large number. And down here, this gives you an idea what sort of pressure change accompanies a flow change. For in a steel pipe, a 1 foot per second change in velocity will produce a 50 to 60 PSI wave. So that's quite a large wave, and that's what is so significant. Here, we can use this simple approach to estimate the effects of a surge. For example, the maximum upsurge due to the closure of a valve, if you have initial velocity, say, of 6 feet per second or 2 meters, we can calculate it from this simple equation. It would be about 750 feet or 230 meters. The maximum downsurge also is computed based on the velocity change, and that would be minus 750 feet or 230 meters. So it's very significant, and this very simple calculation can help you estimate that. The wave speed is given by this equation. As the thickness of the pipe decreases, the pipe is more flexible, we get a reduction in wave speed. So there is some help on your in your Surge 2000 that will help you calculate the wave speeds. Now the program itself consists of a subroutine to handle components, where a wave comes in, it changes the conditions at the components, there's a reflected and a transmitted wave. This includes components, includes valves, and on valves we have relationships for the area going through the valve that the water sees versus the stem position. And these sort of relationships are available and are used within the program to model valves. Pumps, you can model pumps two ways. We can use just a standard ABC characteristic. This works only for normal operation. If we have a pump trip where the pump can turbine and the flow can reverse, we have to use these Suter diagrams, which are dynamic characteristics over an entire range of possible. For junctions, if a pressure wave approaches a junction, you'll get a transmitted wave into the junction and a reflected wave back. These are quite simple to calculate. And here's an example. If we had a 100-foot wave approaching this junction with these characteristics, this is the wave speed over GA, we would get a wave of 114, actually a magnification of the wave being transmitted down, and a reflected wave of 14 going back. Open and closed ends are sort of special cases. A wave at an open end is reflected negatively. A wave at a closed end is reflected positively. Both of these have a profound effect on the transient response. closed ends because of the positive reflection can increase pressures even further in a pumping system. We have surge control devices. These are almost always based on flow entering or leaving the system, and we set up a subroutine to handle these devices. These include open and closed surge tanks, feed tanks, bladder tanks, pressure relief valves, surge anticipation valves, and air valves, which have an effective inflow and outflow orifice.